name is Edwin Martinez. I was born and raised in Panama City, Panama. I came to Canada back in 1998. Prior to coming to Canada, I participated in various dance schools in Panama, right from the early stages of my life in primary school. While I was actually waiting for my my landed immigrant paperwork, I started looking into dances to see what I could find. I started teaching. I taught in several places here in Canada, in Thunder Bay, in the 20-something years that I have been here. And eventually, after doing so many classes all over the city and spreading the love and my passion for dancing, I decided to open my own studio, where I started inspiring and spreading my love and passion for dancing and for the various different styles of music. We have salsa, we have merengue, we have bachata, we have semba, we have samba, we have kizomba, we have típico. Típico is one of, is actually the national dance of Panama. While here, it got to a point where I inspired so many of my students that it became a community. It became a bond that was so strong that it was la familia. And along the way, we made the bestest of friends, because again, dancing is about having fun. To me as an owner, to me as an instructor, as an owner back then, an instructor today, my main goal was to spread the love and passion for the multicultural diversities of the different dance styles around the Latin American countries, and also some from Africa as well.
I started Latin dancing back in 2011 in Montreal at a small school called Saint-Tropez Dance School. It's not small anymore, but that's where I had my first taste in salsa, bachata, and merengue. And I've been hooked ever since. I moved to Thunder Bay in 2014, and I was a bit reluctant coming from a big city, metro city, to a small community of 120,000 people. And I made sure to check if there's any Latin dance community, and I could not really find much, but I was able to find Edwin's school at the time. It was mostly being offering at the time cardio salsa, and when I joined, right away I was welcomed in. I felt like I belonged right away. And then within one week, my first week here, I was already friends with a group of 20 people right away. And that just made me want to settle even longer and stay in Thunder Bay. It just made my transition way smoother. I have a big passion for salsa. I enjoy other dances, but salsa is my go-to. In 2018, a couple from Europe took the opportunity to start the Latin Dance Thunder Bay Facebook page, and we started meeting at the Urban Abbey Church on Red River Road every Thursday. And we did have, a great success, because we're still running now, even post-pandemic. I've always heard from people who started dancing, you know, after me, the benefits mainly, like, pretty fast, you're gonna increase your circle of friends, you're gonna, you know, get way more confidence, more relaxed when you're dancing with strangers or, you know, talking to strangers. It's a very social thing to do.
I always say that I didn't go looking for dance. Dance found me, because I knew the importance of dance in helping with my kids, so I put my kids in dance, but I never thought of dance for myself. And so when my friend Isabel told me about this new dance coming to town called Kizomba and that I should attend, I was intrigued because I never really thought about dance for myself. And so that was my first taste of dance. So I was, you'd say a late starter in dance. And I just remember the first time I stepped into the class, Edwin was like very exuberant. And he's like, hi, how are you? And I was like, oh, okay, hi. And I really loved the class. I thought it was amazing. But in my head, I was thinking, well, when am I going to have time to fit this into my schedule? I'm so busy with my kids, running around with them with all their various activities. And so every time I went to dance class, I felt like I was starting from scratch because I wasn't doing it consistently. So I'd go to a class and then a month later take another class. And it's like, I just felt like I wasn't going anywhere. And finally, in April of 2015, I said, you know what? I really like this. I need to start doing this because it's so much fun. And so I started consistently going to Kizomba class every week. And from there, I added bachata. Then I added salsa. And before you know it, I was at the studio 5 nights a week. So I really got into it. I started going to dance congresses to try and improve my way of dance or my ability to dance. And eventually I got into teaching with Edwin. So I was assistant instructor with him. And so one day when Edwin said that he was going to be closing his studio for various reasons, I was devastated. I just couldn't imagine not having dance in my life. So I asked him about doing some classes in my house where I used to live. And so we were doing some classes there. And then eventually I said, you know what, Edwin? I really want to have my own dance studio. I want to teach. I don't just want to dance. I want to share this joy that I have for dance with other people. When I started dance, I was having issues with my marriage. And dance was a great outlet for me. And I didn't realize how much it helped me until my son one day said to me, Mom, I'm so happy that you're doing dance because I can see how happy you are. And that really struck me because I didn't think my son even noticed anything. I thought I kept everything well hidden. And I knew that I had to keep dancing, not only for myself, but for my family, because it made them feel a lot happier to see me happy.
The most important part of learning how to dance is having a good time. If you cannot laugh, if you cannot giggle, smile, or have fun in general, dancing is not the right thing for you. Because trust me when I say, I used to have a sign on my door at my studio that says, dance like no one's watching. And the reason being is, it is you, the music, and the dance floor. Nobody else, there's nobody to judge. It is all about truly having fun. When it comes to dancing, you can dance for 8 hours and you don't feel a pain. Wait until the next morning. That's a different story. But when you're in the moment, the vibe and the positive atmosphere and how motivated I get with the energy of the floor, it is such that it just fuels me to dance more. I dance, you know what, anybody can dance. There's no such thing as two left feet. It's just that some individuals have never been exposed to the different dances that we do, but it is easy. I have taught so many people along the way and people that, and feeling accomplished.
So as you can tell, Latin dancing is a lifestyle for me. It took over my life years ago and it's not gonna end soon, maybe until my knees give up, but there will be replacements for these as well. So I'm not gonna quit dancing anytime soon.
I'm just so grateful that I had the dance to get me through the COVID, get me through the pandemic, and just to keep me sane, you know? So my motto for my studio is experience the rhythm, ignite your passion. Because once I experienced the dance, my passion for it was ignited, and I just can't imagine my life without dance.
Yeah.